Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we have a variety of updates from upcoming launches to contract information related to SpaceX. Then we have a whole load of updates over in Boca Chica with infrastructure and Starship information, including the upcoming static fire for SN8. Let's head straight in and get up to date. Starting off today, there was a tweet from SpaceX confirming a successful static fire of the booster that will launch Starlink 13. They confirmed they are targeting liftoff today at 8:25am EDT or 12:25pm UTC. So whilst I'm editing this video, it will very likely have launched. They added to this tweet by saying the booster they will be using, which is B1051, will launch for the sixth time. Also, they said that both fairing halves that will be used will be flying for the third time. Looking at the SpaceXFans website, as well as launching Starlink 13, they are also looking to launch Starlink 14 soon. Starlink 14, or the 15th batch of satellites, is expected to launch on Wednesday at 6:36pm UTC or 2:36pm EDT. Jeff Faust tweeted, "At the Sentinel 6 briefing, NASA's Tim Dunn says launch preparations on a Falcon 9 are going incredibly well, still scheduled for November 10th. NASA's Tim Dunn apparently also said the engine investigation after a Falcon 9 abort 2 weeks ago is ongoing, including taking the engines from the vehicle back to McGregor for testing. There is a path forward for any rework needed for the Sentinel 6 launch while keeping the November 10th launch date." There's an article which says that SpaceX and some other companies are eligible to compete for a share of the $20.4 billion in broadband subsidies the FCC plans to dole out. In another article by Space News, apparently SpaceX is looking at ways it could provide weather data to the US military. It says the company is working under a $2 million 6-month study contract. NASA released a post about a bunch of companies, of which SpaceX is one, who have been selected to help mature cryogenic fluid management technologies via in-space demonstrations. Ron Barron, who is a billionaire investor and owns shares of Tesla and has made quite the return, says SpaceX could be as large as Tesla someday. With those standard SpaceX updates addressed, let's check out what's been happening in Boca Chica. Firstly, they are currently preparing to expand a wall around the launch area. They've recently been doing work on the landing pad, and here is the latest view of how that is coming along. In preparation for the upcoming static fire testing expected for the SN8 prototype, some propellant was delivered. Also in the launch area are some new and interesting pieces spotted sitting on the ground. Jack Byer says maybe these pieces are for a tent they might be planning to construct there. Over near the production area of the facility, some new arrivals were spotted with these crane pieces seen being delivered. As well as the wall at the launch area, they've recently started adding shipping containers at the build site. You can see that more have since been added, and so a metal wall may go up soon. With the high bay getting very near completion, engineers have been working on this unfinished side of the building. Also by the construction area, some groundwork has been going on. They've been clearing up the land between the production area and Boca Chica village just next door. With those infrastructure updates covered, we have some Starship and Mars updates. Elon Musk spoke at the Mars Society conference a couple of days ago, and somebody summarized the main points. For Starship updates, Musk said there's an 80-90% chance of orbit next year, 50-60% chance of recovery and first flight, likely to lose some Starships. Full production and regular orbital flights no earlier than 2022. Also, Starship orbital refueling no earlier than 2022. Moonship prototypes no earlier than 2022 to 2023, and an optimistic timeline for flights of cargo to Mars on Starships in the 2024 window. Then, Musk gave some updates about Mars, such as biggest priority is propellant plant. Best place to land, mid-latitudes, not too far from ice and not too far from the equator for best isolation and air braking. Could deploy Starlink around Mars and use laser relays between the planets. Finally, boring company tunnels could be used. Tunnels are important, but equipment needs to be very light. Some optimistic but exciting updates. However, let's take a look at Starship pieces in Boca Chica, starting with this new two-ring stack that was moved outside. It was moved over to their large and growing collection of ring stacks out in the yard. Some of these are very likely Starship sections and others potentially super heavy. Also spotted sitting out in the yard is this new methane header tank for landing propellant storage and will be welded to a common bulkhead. There's a bulkhead that's been worked on and was lifted onto the sleeving mount. This dome has some interesting cutouts. We saw the fairing section moved out of the windbreaker last episode. It has since been worked on. They recently moved the hardware that was attached to be able to lift this. Moving on, we now have pieces of SN8 as well as recent and upcoming testing to take a look at. Firstly, you can see that sitting behind one of the older noses is a ring stack which has been worked on and now has lead-ins. This barrel section was also hooked up to a crane in order to be lifted so it can be stacked with a nose. Then, sitting inside the windbreaker building is the new nose cone we saw get cannered last episode and is pretty much complete. Both of these sections are for the SN8 vehicle. This great shot of the two side by side was captured and it shouldn't be long at all before they are joined with one another. This will then be the fairing for SN8, very exciting. Looking at the SN8 tank though, in preparation for the static fire testing, engineers were working on the Raptor engines. Also in preparation for testing, they were seen doing work around the tank. On Friday, SpaceX geared up for what we were expecting first, maybe a pre-burner test of the engines. During this testing procedure, something we've not seen before happened. You can see that the tank was venting from three locations, left, center, and right. Whilst we don't know why, some people have suggested maybe a vent per Raptor engine. During this testing, as they often do, they were also seen testing the RCS thrusters situated at the bottom of the tank. However, they reached the end of the test window without doing any pre-burner or static fire test. They did have another window for testing which started a couple of hours later, but that road closure date was cancelled on Friday. Looking at some new dates posted for testing, we could see the tests happen as soon as tonight from 9 p.m. However, should they need more dates, there's also backups on Monday and Tuesday. To finish up this video, we have some other prototypes being worked on to take a look at. Here you can see SN9 currently undergoing preparations for attaching the body flaps. Alongside SN9, the first SN10 barrel section to be moved into the midbay was spotted and it's the middle locks ring stack. Not long after, SN10's common bulkhead ring stack was lifted and also moved into the midbay. The two were then stacked with one another to be welded together. With that, we also have the latest build diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. I think it's insane that SpaceX are working so fast they are already in the process of stacking SN10. Finally, I want to show you another fantastic image created by Brendan Lewis. Here you can see the current state of every one of the builds SpaceX has been working on as well as their lineup of existing Starships. Just quickly, I want to say that we have a Discord server, so if you want to come and say hi, there's a link in the description. As always though, an enormous thank you to the one and only Mary or Boca Chica girl for her time and dedication to filming this epic stuff. Also, an enormous thank you to the rest of the NASA spaceflight team who all do incredible work behind the scenes and particularly with their incredibly late live streams. We all greatly appreciate what you guys are doing. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.